Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to calculate the derivative of a parametric curve and then find the equation of the tangent line at a particular point, t. We'll calculate three values to complete this problem. First, we'll find the x-coordinate at the given point, t. Second, we'll find the y-coordinate at the given point, t. Then finally, we'll calculate the derivative of the parametric curve and use it to find the slope, m, at the given point, t. Let's get started. And you'll remember that a parametric curve can't be defined by one function of y in terms of x. So in order to define it, we have to have two equations, one for y and one for x, that are both in terms of a third parameter, t. And in this particular problem, we've been given our two equations, one for y and one for x, and asked to find the derivative of this parametric curve at the point t equals pi over 2. So you'll remember from our work with derivatives before that in order to find the derivative of a function at a point, we just need to find the equation of the tangent line at that point. So we can model the equation of the tangent line with the point slope form of the equation for a line, which is y minus y1 equals m for slope times x minus x1, or x sub 1. And with this equation, we're going to need to find three things. We need to find y sub 1 and x sub 1, which will be the values that our x and y equations return to us when we plug in the point t equals pi over 2. And we need m, which we'll need to find by taking the derivative of these parametric equations. First, let's find x sub 1 and y sub 1 by plugging the point t equals pi over 2 into our equations for x and y. Before we do that, let's go ahead and simplify our x and y equations. We can simplify them somewhat by distributing the 3 across this value here. So we'll get 3t minus 3 sine t for x. And for y, we'll get 3 minus 3 cosine of t. That'll make it a little easier for us to plug in t equals pi over 2 to these equations. So let's say that if we plug in t equals pi over 2 to our x equation, we'll get 3 times pi over 2 minus 3 sine of pi over 2. Obviously that will give us 3 pi over 2 out in front minus sine of pi over 2, which will be 1. 3 times 1 is just 3, so we'll get minus 3. And we can simplify this somewhat by finding a common denominator. So we'll get 3 pi over 2 minus 6 over 2, which will give us 3 times pi minus 2 all over 2. And since this is the value we found when we plugged in pi over 2 to our x equation, this will be equal to x sub 1. Now we need to find y sub 1, and we'll do that by plugging pi over 2 in for t into our y equation. So we're going to plug that in here, and we'll get y equals 3 minus 3 cosine of pi over 2. When we evaluate cosine of pi over 2, we get 0, so we'll get 3 minus 3 times 0, or 3 minus 0, which of course is just 3. And we know now that 3 is equal to y sub 1. So now that we have these two points, we can go ahead and plug them into our point slope form of the equation of the tangent line. So we'll get y minus 3 is equal to m times x minus 3 times pi minus 2 all over 2. And now what we need to find is m. So in order to find m, we need to take the derivative of our parametric curve. We have two equations for our parametric curve, so we're going to need a formula to take the derivative of these two equations at one time. And the way that we're going to write out our formula is this. The derivative of dy over dx, or the derivative of our function, will be equal to the derivative of our equation for y with respect to t divided by the derivative of our equation for x with respect to t. So dy over dx is equal to dy dt over dx dt. So you'll notice that we'll need to calculate the derivative of y with respect to t and plug that into our numerator, and then calculate the derivative of x with respect to t and plug that into our denominator. So let's go ahead and do that.
We'll take the derivative of our equation for y, and again, we're looking now at this equation that we simplified. This is the equation for y, and we want to take the derivative of that with respect to t. So the derivative of 3, that first term, will just be 0, and then the derivative of negative 3 cosine of t will be positive 3 sine t. It's actually negative 3 sine t, but because we have that negative already there, it turns into a positive. And now that we have the derivative of our y function, we can go ahead and take the derivative of x. For x, we'll be looking at this equation here that we simplified, 3t minus 3 sine of t, and we'll be taking the derivative of that with respect to t. So the derivative of 3t with respect to t is just 3, and then the derivative of negative 3 sine t is negative 3 cosine of t. When we simplify this, we'll see that we get 3 sine of t, and then in our denominator, we can factor out a 3, and we'll get 1 minus cosine of t. And you can see now that we'll get our 3s to cancel, and our simplified derivative equation will be sine of t all over 1 minus cosine of t. Now, if we had just been asked to find generically the derivative of this parametric curve, this here would be our answer, sine of t divided by 1 minus cosine of t. But because we've been asked to find the derivative at a particular point, we'll want to plug in pi over 2 for t so that we can get something we can plug in for m into our equation for the tangent line. So we'll go ahead and plug in pi over 2 to our derivative function, and we'll get sine of pi over 2 divided by 1 minus cosine of pi over 2. We know that sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1, so we'll get 1 here in the numerator. We know that cosine of pi over 2 is equal to 0. 1 minus 0 just gives us 1, so we have 1 over 1, and we can see that our final answer here will be 1. That's what we'll go ahead and plug in for m. So plugging 1 in for m, we'll see that we get y minus 3 equals, we'll just go ahead and leave out the 1 because it's redundant, and we'll have x minus 3 times pi minus 2 all over 2. And we can leave our equation in this form, but because we're so close to slope-intercept form, why don't we just go ahead and move that 3 over to the right-hand side, and we'll finish our equation here as y equals x minus 3 times pi minus 2 all over 2, and then we'll have plus 3. I want to go ahead and say, we'll say plus 6 over 2, right? And then we can combine these terms because we have a common denominator. Let's go ahead and call this 3 pi minus 6. So this will turn into y equals x minus 3 pi minus 6 plus 6 all over 2. And you can see that the 6s will cancel here, and we'll be left with y equals x minus 3 pi over 2. And that's it. That's our final answer. This is the equation of the tangent line at the point t equals pi over 2, or the derivative at t equals pi over 2 of the parametric equation that's modeled by these two original equations here for x and y.
So I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.